Hello, beautiful people. Today we're gonna play with Skellige, with the Blaze of Glory, one of my favorite archetypes of Skellige. And this is basically focused on warriors in this deck. And you have pretty much the strongest warriors in the Skellige Blaze of Glory archetype. Some things which are missing. Obviously, out of all the cards, there are a few question marks, but I would say this option is the best here, and I wouldn't like to change it. First of all, King Brand is missing, but what I would say is that there is no point of inserting him in this deck because he doesn't give you that much value regarding this this deck. Also, if you're gonna let me say. Sorry, if you're gonna see the deck here, faction, and here, you wouldn't have Harald Uncrate, but I counted, you know, how much value he can give to us regarding this deck, and it's not worth it. So what I would say is that these are the best options that we have over here, and now let me just walk you through the cards and let's discuss the strategy. So obviously the leader ability here is gonna be Blaze of Glory. What we're gonna use over here, the unit that we're gonna move, obviously, which is pretty amazing, is gonna be Yuta for only 6 points of provision. Not only he gives 13 points of damages to our opponent, but also he remains on board. So basically, this is like a using leader ability plus this 6 point. It will give us 26 points altogether of value, which is absolutely amazing. Mask of Ouroboros for consistency. And guys, I mean, this deck is pretty complicated because you need to remember about the sequencing. It's not that easy, and there are some cards that you need to, you know, at all times they need to stay in our deck. Other than this, there are some cards that they need to stay in our hand, so it's pretty difficult. So you need to focus and you need to follow the sequencing because it's not, I would say, an easy deck to play. Mask of Ouroboros, and what I like to do, I would like to discard always an Uncrate Warrior. And why am I doing this? Because later on, if we're gonna play War of Clans, then we're gonna basically summon our. Not only we're gonna give, you know, I would say five or even si sorry, six or seven even points of sorry. 5 points of damages, 5 points of damages, but also we will summon one of these cards. And this, if it's gonna be Uncrate Warrior, so then we're gonna give automatically 3 points of damage instead of bleed. So this we're gonna play for 5 plus 3 for 8. So 8 plus obviously this Uncrate power, so it's gonna be 12 for 6. So you're gonna double the value of the card, and then you have like also a toll point removal because you will be able to destroy a unit which is 8 points of power. Anyway, let's go back to the deck. Obviously, Tyr Slayer, we would like to play the premium version of him. It doesn't have to be the first card that you're gonna play in the round three, but you should focus on having at that time cards like Fukuxia and cards like War of Clans, because you're gonna summon the units from your graveyard. So basically, you would like to summon one of these invaders. Because she will have at that time 7 points of power, so you will have a 14 points power unit. And at the same time, what gives us tier is that if you're gonna brick and you will have in your hand some kind of a card which is useless. For instance, let me say in third round, usually what you can get is, let me say, Uncrate Warrior or Savage Bear, or maybe one of these Brockvar Warriors. So then you can get rid of them, discard them, and instead of this, get a 14 points of power unit. And you can do it even 3 times, so you can summon both of them. And let me say some, I don't know, some other unit like Brockvar Warrior or Uncrate Warrior, if at that time it's still not summoned. Anyway, Fukuxia, she will be played into Highland Warrior to get 5 rounds of rain. Blood Eagle, for consistency, and this is super important card for us, because in round one we can get Highland Warrior, but in the second or the third round we can get one of our gold warriors. Then solve, and you need to keep in mind that you need to play him in the first round or the second round. Don't you know, be shy on it, and I'm just go for it, because we need certain things in our graveyard. And basically him, not only he will create a huge tempo, especially for a second round, and we can bleed our opponent, but also we're gonna keep him in our graveyard, and by doing this we have a amazing target for our Hjalmar. And also in the same round, even if he's gonna get destroyed, then you will get another target for Svanrich. So I would say it's gonna work, because sometimes you will keep your leader ability till the third round, and then you need to depend on Yuta. So it's very important to have one of these cards, Sov or Yuta, by the end of round two. You need to use one of them, so you can have them in the graveyard for third round. All right. Then the next card, this is super amazing card, Aced, and what is good about it is that you're playing this card obviously into our leader, and then Yuta, he will, instead of remaining in the graveyard, he will be placed back on our board. Then we have Hjalmar, banish a unit in your graveyard and damage opponent. So we need to have Sov, or we need to have Yuta, and then we will have we'll deal 12 or 13 points of damages to our opponent, Svanrich. And this is very important to play him just after you will use your leader ability, and you will use Yuta, unless Sov got destroyed, and then you will play Svanrich, and then instead of 13 points of power, he will receive 12 points of boost. Vabjorn, this is our consistency. Usually I play him into Blood Eagle, but if I already have it in my in my hand, then I play into some other raid. War of Clans, we have two of them, so make sure that you have two bronze warriors in your graveyard. Stunning Blow, this card is especially good against defenders. By the end of our round 3, he will deal 8 points of damages regularly, but if this is a unit with armor, so then he will give he will deal 10 points of damages. Highland Warriors, just to increase the value of our raids. Gutting Slash, just make sure that the Bloodthirst is 2. Primal Savagery, also amazing card. For 4 points of value, it plays for 10 points, because then it's gonna be 4 or even 5 points of damages, so it can even play for 11. Little Hafru, that's a target for Sov. Two warriors, just to have them in our graveyard. The second optional target for our Sov. And Brockvars, just to just to increase the value of Bloodthirst. So guys, that's the deck. It's pretty amazing. It can challenge all the meta decks. Then only it depends on drawing. If you get Highland Warriors quickly, and you will get all the necessary golds, basically you can win with any kind of a deck. But unfortunately, if our first round is very weak, we didn't get two of the Highland Warriors, and in the third round we didn't get our golds, then if our opponent were gonna bleed us in round two, it's gonna be difficult for us. So it can be very good, and you can just win 10 games in a row, but at the same time, if something goes wrong with our drawings, then you can lose maybe like 3 or 4 games in a row. But I would say this deck, it's very very good. I love playing with it. You have not only units that will gonna have a high value, but also you are dealing great damages. So thank you very much for watching, thank you for your time and support. Please like, subscribe and comment. See you guys in the next video. And last announcement guys, please go to the nearest shelter and adopt a dog. Thank you very much guys, bye bye.
Fashion! Shall be proud of his sons.
is it?
One step!
From Caith.
Dead road! No Abel road!
Ah!
your ankle biters too.
Reasons for the feeble of heart!
Walk away from this.
Next, Tedaku.
averting.
Did Freya choose the victor? Do I enjoy torture? Perhaps. A bit.
My prescription, a bit of bloodletting.
On thy courageous mother.
Wake me when you're done.
Thank you. rather die than appease the Emperor.
Long live Eccentric.
Hold up, Skellige, with our bare hands.
against all mice.
I shall come. I shall see. I shall conquer.
Sea devil!
I shall be with you shortly.
Skeletor and Cypher shall stand ever together.
Sword, back sword, army sword, bastard sword.
Get thee behind me!
Washes away all shame!
Foul blood!
Stench of fear. I knows it well.
I'm just a sexy little cog in a fucked up machine called life.
End you.
You heard about Tridam Ultimatum?
Skellige with our bare hands.
I don't have a dirty mind, just one hell of an imagination.
Your ankle by the tail.
You wouldn't want to hurt us, would you?
Thank you.
Come on! Show us what you got!
Awaiting your orders. No audiences this day.
Blood for foul blood!
But we're broke as shit peddlers.
Brings you here.
Mother!
Left, right, left, right.
Hands. One's head. Sacrifices for Melusine, one and all.
Reasons for the fable of heart!
Being disturbed.
We'll follow you always! Into the fair!
like a seal!
Control the docks, control the city.
I'll wash it all away.
No one comes to show it!
Only one of us will still stand by the end of the day.
The simplest methods are the best.
Remember, this'll be our little secret.
Die already, or need I kill you again? Look closely, kiddos. I'm thy courageous mother.
You nutsack!
Damn it!
A beautiful pair of legs here.
Got you like fishing!
Skelligar and Sinfer shall stand ever together.
So? No one else dares face me?
I pass on every 10th round.
I'm a boss, sir.
It hasn't backfired yet.
Closely, kiddos, on thy courageous mother. Dares face me?
You stand before His Royal Majesty.
Thank you.
field on both sides.
I don't know why not walk away from this.
With our bare hands.
Never ever.
racists.
Reasons for the feeble of heart!
May your sword and arm be one.
I...
Best drown yourself with those damn nets.
Clever tactic, but it will get you nowhere.
Closely, kiddos, on thy courageous mother.
No retreat! Not one step!
Exactly what I hoped for.
Take care of myself.
Look what the werecat dragged in.
like a seal!
Care of myself?